flight school. My name is Jackson, with a J. And I'll be your instructor. First things first. Let's see if we can get you into the air without killing yourself or someone else. We're gonna start with a basic takeoff. Hold the throttle all the way down to pick up speed, and pull back on the stick to take off. You can retract your landing gear once you're a safe distance above the ground. Congratulations, pilot! You are now airborne. Now, navigate through those checkpoints marked on your radar, and we can move on to the next lesson. That was a good start! Well done! On the runway. You won't have many chances to get this wrong, so please follow my instructions very closely. Start reducing the plane's altitude gradually so you're just above the runway as you approach. Be sure to deploy the landing gear before you reach the runway. Start to decelerate while you're still in the air, but be careful not to stall the engine. Executed like a pro! Now let's get the plane off the runway. Taxi over to the marked area and come to a complete stop. That was an excellent landing! Very well done! Performing a couple of different stunts. We'll start you out with a few barrel rolls. And if that goes well, you can take a crack at flying upside down. All right, pilot. It's time for us to get a little crazy. First, I want you to get some altitude and head for that checkpoint marked at the end of the runway. Good. Okay, let's see what you got. On my mark, perform a barrel roll by pulling your flight stick to the left or right. Okay, perform a barrel roll. Stones of steel! I like it. Now let's try a few of those in a row. Level out your plane and get ready. I want to see you do 3 barrel rolls in a row on my signal. Watch your altitude on this one. Okay, perform 3 barrel rolls in a row. Very nice! Are you getting dizzy in there yet? Go ahead and level out the plane again. Now let's see how you do upside down. On my word, roll over the plane and hold it steady. Okay, roll the plane upside down. Hold the plane upside down for several seconds. Right side up. Great work out there today. I'll teach you some more moves next time. Lesson will help you build your stick and rudder skills. You have to keep your plane steady while rolled over on either side. Perfecting this trick will really come in handy in the later lessons. Take off and head for the checkpoint marked at the runway. Then, I'll talk you through it. A knight is one of the harder moves. You'll have to keep your wings steady and use your rudders to maintain altitude. When I give you the signal, I want you to try to hold a knife edge with your plane. Okay, perform a knife edge. Perfect. Now hold that position. Don't forget to use your rudders to maintain altitude. Level out the plane. Good. Let's see if you can do the same thing on the other side. On my mark, roll your plane over to the opposite side and hold the position. Okay, perform a knife edge on the other side. Level out the plane. That was an amazing run! You should be very proud of yourself. How to get better control over your turns. The course goes around the harbor, and you have to stay low to make the checkpoints. You'll need to use your rudders to help you make some of the sharp turns. I want you to use everything you've learned so far to navigate this course as fast as you can. Watch your altitude, though. This is really a test of how low you can go and how well you can maneuver the plane. I'm going to teach you how to perform an emergency landing. Remember to begin decelerating while you are still airborne for a smoother touchdown. Then, once you're on the ground, the brakes should bring you to a full stop very quickly. Okay, do you see your checkpoint marked on the radar? You're going to practice an emergency landing on that bridge straight ahead. Slow your approach as you descend descend onto the road. If you touch down smoothly, your plane is going to stop pretty fast. That was an excellent landing. Very well done. Loop can be a little disoriented, so we'll see how you do under pressure. Make sure you start this stunt from a completely level position. It's also important to remember to pull your stick back as straight as you can so you don't get thrown into a spiral. Take off and head for the marker at the end of the runway. Some pilots find these moves particularly tricky, so it might take you a few tries. Always make sure your plane is straightened out before you attempt an inside loop. On my mark, pull back hard on the flight stick and hold it. Okay, perform an inside loop. Get ready to level out the plane when you're near the end of the loop. That wasn't too bad for a rookie. Let's try it again. Just like before, steady the plane first, wait for my signal, and then pull back hard on the flight stick. Okay, perform an inside loop. Get ready to level out the plane when you're near the end of the loop. Now we're talking! You're doing good so far. I think we can squeeze in one more stunt. We'll combine the inside loop with the barrel roll to perform a roll off the top. Start with an inside loop, but only go halfway. When you're fully inverted, then roll the plane over. Now, when I give you the go-ahead, yank the flight stick back as hard as you can. Ready? Perform a roll off the top. Now, roll the plane right side up. Good job! Hard to believe you were only a beginner not that long ago. We're gonna put you in a helicopter for this lesson. There are a few more controls than the stunt plane, but it's a little more forgiving. Try to finish the obstacle course without bursting into a ball of fire. And sign the waiver. Let's go on a short tour of the city, and we'll see how well you handle the chopper. Follow the marked course, and remember, I'm looking for maneuverability, but also speed. Awesome! Nicely done! The bridge didn't seem to slow you down at all. Nicely done! Very nice! You've got this! Yeah. pad. Go ahead and set her down nice and easy. That's it. I'm very impressed. Maybe you're a helicopter guy after all. Lesson, but with a real emphasis on speed this time. Finish the obstacle course around the city before the timer runs out, and try not to crash. At the end of the course, you'll be required to safely land your helicopter. Remember, this course is all about speed. To maximize acceleration, keep the nose of the helicopter tipped. Just bear in mind that you're also losing altitude when the nose is pointed down. Good work so far. Keep her at full speed. You're looking good. Great out there! Bring the helicopter down gently onto the helipad. I can't find much to fault there. That was a great run. How to fly a helicopter. Now you're gonna learn how to jump out of one. Aim for the landing target and pull your chute when you get close to the ground. The parachute is difficult to control, so slow your approach and give yourself extra time to correct. Hope you aren't afraid of heights. excellent jump! That was almost dead on! Involves skydiving onto a moving target, so I hope you brought a change of underwear. The target will be circling around the runway, so watch it carefully and pay attention to the route. It may take several tries, but once you get this down, you'll be terrorizing drivers all over Los Santos. The drop zone is on the back of a moving truck. So take your time maneuvering with your parachute. It's better to pull your chute early than late. It will give you more time to track the target and try to match its speed. Extremely dangerous stunts with highly populated city areas in an assault course that will put everything you've learned during your time in flight school to the test. For your sake, I hope you've been practicing knifing and flying upside down. I want you to take your very best shot at this obstacle course. There are going to be special gates that will require you to fly upside down or knife through them. A good line. that look easy? Brings a tear to my eye to see how far you've come.